Hello, this is Kevin Bacon again. And the question was asked, can I cook with a 10-inch fry pan on this little stove? And quite frankly, I didn't design it for a 10-inch fry pan, but what the heck? Let's give it a try. It's awful windy out here. It's coming and going, but we're going to give this a try. First thing I do is I put some sticks and stuff down in the top, because I like to get this chimney nice and hot. I put some fuel in the bottom here, in this case a little bit of newspaper type material, and then I'm going to light the end of this paper towel roll that I've stuffed some newspaper in and use that for a torch. May not work. Oh, there we go. There we go. She's starting to draw flame through the stove. It'll light that small wood on fire fairly quickly. Now the idea of getting the small wood on fire, like I say, is to get this stove hot. As soon as I get a good draft and everything going, I'll start feeding it from down below. All right, that didn't take very long. And as I've said in previous videos, I like to keep things real. It's windy out here. Typically, if you're cooking outside, you're gonna deal with wind. So it's only fair that we deal with some wind. Okay, the flames are licking out the top pretty good. These twigs will burn down, and they could be pickup off the ground twigs, but what I had handy today was a short chunk of 2x4 and a little bit of other pine. It'll be a little smokier than normal. All right, still pretty smoky. I haven't got it up to temperature, but I did go ahead and throw the fry pan on there. And you look at it, you'll see it dwarfs this little stove pretty good. Now, I'm not sure of the size of this pan. I'll measure it better, but this is a standard small dinner plate, and it would fit inside of that fry pan. This is a fry pan I carried all over northern Michigan when I was in college. It's a heavy monster, but it cooked an awful, awful lot of brook trout. Well, I wish I could show you, but I haven't even got the fire going full blast, and the water is boiling. I just washed this pan, and I didn't dry it, and the water inside the pan that was left on it is boiling. So, we're mostly burning paper towel tube here with a little newspaper stuck in it and a few twigs that were dropped down the top. And we've already got the pan steaming and boiling. Yeah, I don't think there's going to be any problem as long as you pay attention to the fact that you got to make sure you're not going to tip this thing over while you're working with it. And I have placed it here in perhaps the worst of conditions where it's not on a real stable base or anything like that, because once again I want a fair and honest demonstration. Hey, she's hot. I'm going to get this thing around here where I can see down in the pan. I'm going to throw in a little butter. Thank you. It doesn't take long to get a sizzle on that butter. Put the lid back on it here for a minute. Alright, it's time to throw in a couple eggs. And I say a couple, that's all I got, so that's what we're going to get. A little salt. A little pepper. Getting a little ash from that newspaper. Okay. Time to stir these up. See, the whites are pretty well already cooked. Give those a few more seconds and they're done. So I'm guessing the answer is yeah, I can cook with a 10-inch fry pan on this little stove, and wasn't any more difficult than it might have been if I was cooking on the kitchen stove, except that I got a camera in the way and it's windy out here, and those eggs are done. Throw them on a plate. And there's breakfast, ready to go. Yep, it's a success. Kevin Bacon, thanks for watching. Bye. Okay, now the big question is, what am I going to do with all this leftover wood? Because I burned less than half of those little sticks, and whatever was in the chimney, a little piece of newspaper, and a paper towel roll to cook my dinner. Well, in this case, breakfast.
It was great eggs. I liked them very much.
See, unpaid endorsement.
Yeah.